Hello guys, my name is Archana Devi. I am an assistant professor from Rajagiri School of Engineering. So this video lecture is from the subject Principles of Database Design from Module 4 as part of RSET Online. The topic is how to find the minimal cover or it's also termed as canonical cover given a set of functional dependencies. So let's try to understand what this minimal cover is. Given a set of functional dependencies, F. The minimal cover FC is the minimal set of FDs. FDs meaning functional dependencies. So it's a minimal set of FDs that is equivalent to F and have no redundant FD or redundant attribute. So no redundant FD and no redundant attribute. So you are given a set of functional dependencies. You are going to find the minimal set of functional dependencies, removing redundant FDs and removing redundant attributes. So what is meant by this redundant FD and redundant attributes? Look at this example. Suppose if this is your set of functional dependencies given, this is your F. So now in this, if you want to find out if there is any redundant functional dependency, you can see that here A determines B and then B determines C. So using transitivity rule, the inference rule, using that rule, you can write A determines C. Right, A determines B and B determines C, therefore A will determine C. So this is a redundant functional dependency here. And now the next case where you are trying to find out redundant attribute. So now look at this example, AB giving C and A giving C. So in this example, this FD says A determines C. So if A determines C, then in this functional dependency, B is a redundant attribute. Because if A alone can determine C, then in this functional dependency, A doesn't need the attribute B to determine C. So B here is redundant. Here the word, the redundant attribute is also called as an extraneous attribute. Extraneous attribute, okay? Now, let us try to see what are the steps in order to find out the minimal cover given a set of FDs. So there are three basic steps to be followed. The first step is, given the set of functional dependency, make the right hand side, RHS's right hand side, singleton. That is using decomposition rule. Say for example, if you have a functional dependency like this, A giving BC. So make the RHS singleton. So you can rewrite this as A giving B and A giving C. Using decomposition rule, split the functional dependency. That is the first step. Now the second step is remove the extraneous attribute, that is redundant attributes in LHS. And the third step is remove the redundant FDs. After removing all extraneous attributes, you will get a set of functional dependencies. In that you have to remove the redundant functional dependencies. So now let's before moving on to how to find the minimal cover, you should know how to remove the extraneous attribute. So for that, there is actually a small algorithm. So using this algorithm, you can understand how this extraneous attribute is removed. See, let us try to understand how this works. So given a functional dependency, alpha to beta. So here you are trying to remove an extraneous attribute in LHS. So here alpha contains more than one attribute. So let X be the element in alpha. If you want to find out if this X is extraneous or not, These are the steps. So if X is extraneous, now let gamma equal to alpha minus X. Say for example, if you have AB, out of this, if you want to find out A, say AB determines C. If you have an dependency like this, if you want to find out if A is extraneous, here X is A, okay, X is A, and then find out gamma. Gamma here is alpha AB minus X, which is A. So alpha is AB minus your A, which is your B. Okay. Now, simply what you have to do here is, you have to find out the closure of gamma. That is what you have to find out. So compute gamma closure. For that we have written, check if gamma gives beta can be inferred from F dash. Okay. So what that means is, let us see what this F dash is. Now you have to find out if this gamma is extraneous, that is redundant or not. In order to find that out, use this f dash, where f dash is nothing but this is a equation for f dash. Now don't get confused, it's simple only. What f dash mean is the actual set of functional dependency, subtract this functional dependency from the actual set of functional dependencies first. So remove it first, and then add this alpha minus x giving beta to f. Say for example, here I am trying to find out if x is extraneous or not, right? So x is extraneous or not. So you remove this dependency as such from the set of functional dependency, and then you add alpha minus x. So here alpha is your ab minus x is a, so that is beta, b giving c. So add this to the functional dependency. So remove this extraneous attribute, that's all, that's what it means. Remove this attribute which you are going to find out if it is extraneous or not from this functional dependency. Now what you have to do is find the closure of gamma from in f dash. Find the closure of gamma. Gamma is nothing but this attribute, okay, not the one which you have removed, the one which is existing in the functional dependency. Find the closure of that in f dash. If the closure of that attribute is the same as the closure of alpha, alpha is ab closure. So if you are able to find out here, if you are able to find out b closure, okay, if you are able to find out b closure, and if it is the same as ab closure, that means, if it is same, means here the x that you have determined, a, is extraneous. Why do you say so? Because if you can find out this gamma closure and you are getting this beta in f dash without the extraneous attribute here x, without x, if you can find out the same f, if can be inferred, that means that attribute is redundant. Okay, so if that is redundant, remove that attribute from this functional dependency. Now if this seems to be confusing, let us try to understand with an example. Okay, so I worked out an example here. So the set of functional dependencies given, b to a, d to a, and ab to d. So now what you have to do here is, here I have this functional dependency ab to d. Here there are two cases, either a can be extraneous or b can be extraneous. So check the two cases, whether a is extraneous or b is extraneous. Okay, so here your alpha is ab and your beta is d. Now let's find if a is extraneous. So x is a, so gamma is nothing but this alpha minus a, which is your b. Now find out gamma closure. You have to find out gamma closure here in f dash. So f dash is nothing but you have to remove this functional dependency ab to d from the original functional dependency. So you give b, so you get b to a, d to a, and then after removing it, you remove the extraneous attribute, which you, if you think that this is the extraneous attribute, remove that from this functional dependency, and so you get b to d. So this is your f dash. Okay, now what you have to do, find out gamma closure. Gamma is nothing but b, so b closure, if you find out in f dash, you have to find out. So b closure, you will get b, you will get, from this you will get a, and then b a, b to d, so you will get b a d. So gamma closure is b a d. Then you have to also find out alpha closure. So alpha is your a b, so a b closure in this f dash. Okay, so a b closure, you will get a b, followed by, since b gives d, you will get d. So you can see that alpha closure and gamma closure are the same. Since they are the same, here a is extraneous, that is, you are able to determine beta without the help of a. So a is extraneous in this functional dependency, so you will remove a from that f dash. So the set of functional dependencies become b to a, d to a, and b to d. So it is an extraneous attribute. Now since we have found out a is already extraneous, b will not be extraneous, but still you can see whether b is extraneous in this example. I have worked out the steps. So here you have your x is b, so your gamma becomes a. Now your f dash becomes the set of functional dependencies after removing a b to d, and then you have to remove x from this functional dependency. X is nothing but b, so you will get a to d. So now find out gamma closure. Gamma closure is a. So A closure you're actually getting as AD only, whereas your alpha closure is ABD. They are not the same. So that means B is an essential attribute. B is not extraneous. B is an essential attribute. Okay. Now, this is a full worked out example to find out the minimal cover for a set of functional dependencies. Okay, so you have three steps. The set of functional dependencies given A to BC, B to C, A to B, and AB to C. So the first step is you have to decompose, right? Make it singleton RHS. Make the right hand side singleton. So you have A to BC, so split it as A to B and A to C. Then you have B to C, A to B, AB to C. So here itself you can see that this functional dependency A to B is repeated. So it's a redundant functional dependency. You can remove it in the beginning itself, A to B. Okay. You can remove it in the beginning itself. Now you have to take this functional dependency AB to C and check if it is whether A and B are extraneous. Okay. Whether A and B are extraneous. There can be the case where both A and B will not be extraneous. In that case, you have to retain both A as well as B. Now, if I want to check if A is extraneous, you have to write the new F dash as remove this AB to C. So you have A to B, A to C, B to C, and then from this functional dependency, remove A. So if you remove A, you will get B to C. But B to C is already there, so this need not be written twice. So now I am checking if A is extraneous, right? So you have to find the closure of gamma. Gamma is the other attribute, which is your B. So B closure, if you find out, you will get in this B closure, you will get B followed by from this dependency, you will get BC. So B closure is BC. Now your alpha is AB. So if you find AB closure, you will get AB followed by, since you have the dependency B to C, you will get B to C, ABC, alpha closure as ABC. So here they are not the same. So that means A is an essential attribute. A is not an extraneous attribute. Now you have to check if B is extraneous, right? So if B is extraneous, you remove B from this functional dependency. So you will get A to C, right? So again, A to C is repeated twice. So you need not consider it twice. Out of this, you have to find out gamma closure and alpha closure. So gamma here is your A, whichever attribute you did not remove, that will be your gamma. So A closure you will get A. So from this AB, right? And then from this you will get ABC as A closure. Now we know that AB closure, you already determined AB closure as ABC. So you can see here that gamma closure and alpha closure both are the same. So if you get both same, that means here B is an extraneous attribute. B is not needed in this functional dependency. So your functional dependency becomes A to B, B to C, and A to C. These are the three functional dependencies, right? These are the three functional dependencies. So this is the second step that we did, removing extraneous attribute. Now the third step is removing redundant functional dependency. So again, here you can see that A to B, B to C, you have. From that, you can determine the dependency A to C using your transitivity rule. So again, this becomes a redundant functional dependency. So your minimal cover or your canonical cover becomes A to B and B to C. This is how you will find out the minimal cover. Okay. Now, I have taken one more case here where in this previous example, we have easily found out if a functional dependency is redundant or not. We just had two simple functional dependencies. From that easily we found out. But there can be case where you may not be able to determine if a functional dependency is redundant or not that easily. So again, there is a easy way to find out if a functional dependency is redundant or not. Okay. So now here in this example, there are three functional dependencies given. I have decomposed it as A to BC, B to AC. I've decomposed it as A to B, A to C. This one, B to A, B to C, and C to A and C to B. So you have to check, you have to take each functional dependency and then check if that is redundant or not. So how to do that is, first you have to find out if this A to B is redundant or not. For that, find out A closure initially. So if you find out A closure, you will get A. From this you will get B, and then using this dependency you will get C. So A closure is ABC. Now what you have to do is remove this functional dependency. Without this functional dependency, see if you are able to find out A closure as the same ABC without the first closure dependency. So if you find out A closure, you will get here AC. Now from C to B, you will actually get ACB. So you can see that even without this functional dependency, you are able to derive all the attributes on the right hand side. That means this is a redundant functional dependency. Now from the next series of steps onwards, you will not consider this functional dependency. This is not there in your F. It has been removed. Now next you have to find out if A to C is redundant. So you will follow the same step. You will find out A closure. Okay. So A closure, you will get A, C, then B. You will get A, C, B. Now you remove this functional dependency. So already A to B has been removed. So consider if A to C is not there, find out A closure. So you will get only A. You are not able to derive C and B. That means this is a essential functional dependency. Okay. This is an essential functional dependency. Now similarly, find out, check if B to A is needed or not. So find B closure initially, considering, including that functional dependency. So you will get B, A, and then since you have A to C, you will get B, A, C. Okay. Now you consider the case if this dependency is not there and find B closure. So you will get B, C you will get, and then from C to A, you will get B, C, A. So that means B closure, you are getting all the attributes without this functional dependency. So this is also redundant. So this is also removed from the set of functional dependencies now. Okay. Now check if the next functional dependency B to C is redundant or not. So if you follow this step, you will get B, C and then A, B closure. Now check the case if you can get B closure as B, A, B, C without this dependency. So without this dependency, you will get B. Now no left hand side gives starts with B, right? So B closure gives B only. So that means this is a essential functional dependency. Now again find check the take the case for the same for C to A and C to B. So find out C closure, you will get C, A, and then since you have C to B, so you will get C, A, B. Now check if this is essential or not. Find out C closure without that dependency, you will get C, you will get C to B, right? You will get C to B. So you can see that you are not able to determine the attribute A. So that means this is essential. Now again find out C closure without this, check to check if this is essential or not. So without this you will get C, you will get A, you are not able to get B. That means again this is also an essential functional dependency. So the minimal cover, okay, after removing the functional dependencies, you are getting the functional dependencies A to C, B to C and C to AB. So this is the minimal cover in this example. Now one thing you must understand here, the minimal cover or the canonical cover need not be unique. Okay, the minimal cover need not be unique. So why do we say that? Need not be unique. It depends upon the order in which you take the functional dependencies. So suppose in this case, you started with A giving B. If you take the case where if you start with A to C followed by A to B and then remaining, if you are following the same order also, I want you to work this out as a homework on your own. So if you take this case, you will be able to find out that this functional dependency A to B which you removed in the beginning will be an essential. This is the one which you will be removing if you follow in this order. So the minimal cover which you find out need not be unique. It depends upon the order in which you determine the functional dependencies. So if you follow the same steps for this, you will actually get the minimal cover as A to B, B to C and C to A. This will be your minimal cover if you take this order. So I want you to work it out and then check if you are able to get this answer. Okay. So I hope you are clear with this lecture, how to find the minimal cover given a set of functional dependencies. Thank you.